Good afternoon, Namaskar. I, Kriti Vadera, would like to welcome all the teachers, learners, educators, students to CIT NCERT's live phone-in program, and you are watching us live on PM eVidya's channel number 9. This session is going to be for standard 9th students. Social science is the subject which we will be discussing in next 30 minutes, and the topic, the chapter which we are going to deal with in this interaction is going to be Rise of Nazis and Hitler. Part 2, it's a follow-up session of, we have already had a introductory session of this chapter, and the expert who has joined us today for this session, I would like to introduce Shri Pavan Kumar Gupta ji. He's PGT History from Kendra Vidyalaya Janakpuri. We welcome you to PM eVidya.
Thank you, ma'am.
And before we start with today's live interaction program, I would like to remind you here that if you have any queries, any questions, any suggestions, then please do let us know. You can dial our toll-free numbers and let us know. Your number would be 8800 440559, and you can also send your questions and queries on the official YouTube streaming of NCERT official, which is happening now. And there is one more medium through which you can contact us. You can mail all your suggestions and questions on dth.class9@ciet.nic.in. So let's begin with today's live interaction program of social science on the chapter Rise of Nazis and Hitler. I welcome you again, Pavan Gupta ji, and because we've already had an introductory session of this particular chapter, I would request you to give us a quick review of whatever we discussed in last session, so that our viewers can remain connected to what we discussed.
Yes, thank you, Kriti, and welcome to all my dear learners. So what we had learnt in our previous session, so many things we learnt in our previous session, just like we came to know the background of First World War. After that, we learnt about the Treaty of Versailles, right? And under the Treaty of Versailles, how insulting treaty was it, and Germany had to sign this treaty. After it, we came to know about the economic problems and economic repression and in Germany and in America. We also came to know about the causes for the rise of Hitler and for the rise of Nazism. In the same way, after it, we also discussed some of the policies of Hitler when he came to came into the power in Germany. So students, today we are going to learn about some of the further policies of Nazism and Hitler. Here we will discuss about the world view of Nazism, that what was their view about the world, what was their view about the Germany. In the same way, here we will also discuss about the racism, right? So the state based on the racism. After it, we will see the condition of youth, how the youths were used in Germany during the Nazism, and what was the condition of ladies. After it, we will also have a look on the Holocaust, what was Holocaust, and how did we came to know about this Holocaust. And after that, we will come to know the mindset of German people during the Nazi Germany. So all these we are going to learn today. So let us start. So first, very first, we will come to know about the world view of Nazi Germany. So under it, we will discuss about the scientific concept of natural selection. Then we will come to know one another scientific concept, that is known as survival of the fittest. And these two scientific concepts were used by the Hitler for his own benefits to establish the racial state in Germany. After it, we will also see the Lebensraum and the establishment of racial state in Germany. So very first, we will talk about the natural selection. So this natural selection was given by Charles Darwin. एंड ही रोट अ वेरी फेमस बुक ऑन द ओरिजिन ऑफ स्पीसीज. सो इन दिस बुक चार्ल्स डार्विन टोल्ड दैट नेचर सिलेक्ट्स दोज प्लांट्स और दोज स्पीसीज विच आर गुड विच कैन मीन्स सर्वाइव. सो दिस थ्योरी वॉज यूज बाय हिटलर फॉर हिज ओन बेनिफिट टू इस्टेब्लिश द रेशियल स्टेट इन जर्मनी. देर वॉज अनदर साइंटिस्ट, ही वॉज हर्बर्ट स्पेंसर. सो दिस हर्बर्ट स्पेंसर ही ऑल्सो इस्टेब्लिश्ड वन अनदर थ्योरी एंड दिस अनदर थ्योरी वॉज द सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट. सो ही रोट अ वेरी फेमस बुक द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ बायोलॉजी. सो इन दिस बुक हर्बर्ट स्पेंसर गेव अनदर थ्योरी द सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट. वॉट डज इट मीन दैट ओनली दैट पर्सन और दैट स्पीसीज कैन सर्वाइव इन दिस वर्ल्ड विच इज फिट. सो ही यूज्ड ऑल दीज साइंटिफिक मेथड्स एंड थ्योरीज दैट इन जर्मनी ओनली द प्योर जर्मन्स कैन सर्वाइव, ओनली द प्योर जर्मन्स आर गुड, ब्लॉन्ड एंड ब्लू आइड जर्मन्स आर गुड. सो इन दिस वे दीज थ्योरीज वर यूज्ड बाय द नाजी जर्मनी फॉर देयर ओन बेनिफिट्स. Now we will come to know.
So can we say, Pavanji, here yes. that Hitler was interpreting these scientific researches, I would say, up yes. to like the way he wanted to.
Yes.
That is what he tried.
Yes, yes. He wanted to use these scientific researches and terms for establishing the racial state,
okay.
and that racial state was based on the races and the supremacy of Aryan. Means he wanted that in Germany only the pure Aryans should live, and those who were gypsies, who were black, particularly who were Jews, they had no any right to live in Germany.
So his dictatorship was fulfilled with these scientific theories.
Yes, he used these scientific theories for establishing his own dictatorship.
For justifying the whatever he was doing.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Right. Correct.
Please continue.
So, students, now we will know another scientific theory, and this scientific theory is related to Lebensraum. So, what is Lebensraum? Lebensraum means living space. So, means he wanted that now the population of pure Aryans was increasing, and for those increasing population, more and more space was needed. So to occupying that space, he started to capture the other nearby areas, the other countries. So Lebensraum was the geopolitical concept, and under this concept, not only he established the supremacy of Germany, but he also started to expand his territory. He started the policy of imperialism in Germany. So in this way, this Lebensraum was used. Now we will see the establishment of racial state. So under this racial state, what we see that Hitler and Nazi party divided all the people in Germany, all the citizens in Germany into two parts. One, who were desirables, and who were the desirables? Particularly pure and healthy Nordic Aryans. So Nordic means particularly the North European countries are known as Nordic countries. So under these, Hitler, he used and he established that in Germany and in those areas which were occupied by Germany, only the pure and healthy Aryans can live. So these persons were desirable, and all other persons were undesirable, including those who were disabled, right? In the same way, who were Jews, gypsies, who were black, all such type of people were categorized into the category of undesirables. So means Jews were particularly the main sufferers in the Nazi Germany. And in our previous session we discussed that why there was enmity between the Jews and the Nazi Germany. So the Nazi Germany, or particularly the Nazi concept, accepted that Jews were responsible for the killing of Jesus Christ. In the same way, they were also usurers. Usurers means जो बहुत ज़्यादा लोन देकर उस पर बहुत ज़्यादा इंटरेस्ट लेते हैं
जी.
तो उनको असरर्स. तो इन दिस वे पर्टिकुलरली ही एस्टेब्लिश द फीलिंग ऑफ हेटर्ड अगेंस्ट
फीलिंग ऑफ हेटर्ड. ओके ओके.
सो इन दिस वे
तो सभी उसकी मोनोपोली के लिए सभी तरीके के जो भी वो अपना सकते थे दांव पेच जनता को भटकाने के लिए या ये रेसिज्म को फैलाने के लिए वो सभी किया जा रहा था.
सभी कुछ किया उसने. और इस तरीके से डिजायरेबल्स और अनडिजायरेबल्स, यानी जो रहने के काबिल हैं और जो रहने के काबिल
नहीं है,
और जो रहने के काबिल नहीं है, देन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट हाउ दीज पीपल वर सेंट टू द कंसंट्रेशन कैंप्स.
राइट.
सो नाउ वी विल सी द रेशियल यूटोपिया. सो अंडर दिस रेशियल यूटोपिया व्हाट वी सी पर्टिकुलरली नॉट ओनली द प्योर जर्मन्स इन जर्मनी but he also captured those children from their mothers who he considered the pure Germans. And these pure Aryan and German children were being tested by the race experts. So those race experts, they tested the children, whether the children was Nordic Aryan or not, pure Aryan or not. And if they proved that such a child was pure Aryan, then those child were acceptable, those children were acceptable, and those who were not proved by the race experts, those were not accepted in the German society. So this was the racial utopia. Now we will see that during the Hitler's time, particularly undesirables were systematically isolated. First, those persons were undesirables were isolated, and then they were executed systematically in Nazi Germany. So very first, exclusion. So under this exclusion, or the policy of exclusion, was adopted during the 1933 to 1939. And here we can particularly give the example of Nuremberg's citizens law. And under this law, what we see that different types of laws were made particularly for the Jews. In this way, they could not hoist the national flag. In the same way, the protection of the state or protection of the country was not provided to them. In the same way, what we see that Jews, those were boycotted on business side. In the same way, those Jews could not marry with any pure German Aryan lady. So in this way, in Nazi Germany, first Jews and other undesirables were systematically separated, and after it, what we see that this process is known as ghettoization. So what this word is, this word has been derived from the word ghettos. So ghettos were particularly the areas which we can compare those areas from today's slum areas. Particularly, all the undesirables were taken to a particular areas, and they were forced to live in those areas. And particularly, those areas were very dirty, and those areas were not worth of living. But undesirables had to live in those ghettos. And during this period, undesirables either their properties and lands were escheated or they were forced to sell their land and property. So the next process was ghettoization. In this way, the third process or third step was annihilation. Annihilation means mass killing. And this mass killing of the undesirables was done after 1941. And under it, what we see that undesirables, Jews, Gypsies and black people, these people were deported to the concentration camps. And what were the concentration camps? Concentration camps were a particular areas where means these undesirables and Jews were being killed at a mass level.
They were being killed actually.
Yes.
And these camps were named as concentration camps. As if some sort of rehabilitation is going on with the people.
Yes, yes.
And they were literally killed there.
Yes. And you will come to know that these concentration camps were made in such a way that these were very good buildings and showers were fitted. And from those showers, particularly poisonous gases were released. And in this way, the mass killing of the undesirables was done in these concentration camps.
Undesirable, the people who Hitler considered as undesirable, who were not Germans.
Germans, particularly Jews and Gypsies. Black people. And even Germans, those Germans who were particularly disabled. So those people were considered as
even if they were Germans, but they were disabled, so he considered themselves as useless and
useless.
These people were shifted to this mass killing.
Yes, yes.
So unfortunate that the history has been this way.
Yes.
You may proceed.
Now learners, we will come to know the condition of youths. So what we see under the Nazi Germany, youths were brought under the Nazi policies and Nazi principle in a systematic way. And as you can see here, very first the other undesirable children and students, those were thrown out from the schools. And this process was known as cleanse and purified or purification of the schools. And after their expulsion, the pure Germans were being taught particularly the principles of Nazi Germany, the theories of Nazism. And what we see that if a children who was up to 10 years old, very first that child had to join the Jungbolk. So this Jungbolk was the organization, and this organization was related to Nazism. And after it, what we see that at the age of 14 years, every child or in the Nazi Germany, that child had to join the Hitler Youth. And Hitler Youth was the organization related to Nazi Party where the Nazi principles and Nazi theories were taught and learnt particularly to the youths. And after completing 18 years, every youth had to join the labor services. After it, they had to join the army. And in the same way, every youth had to join any organization related to Nazi Party. So in this way, what we see that in a very systematic way, Nazi Party and Hitler, they molded the mindset of the youth and they molded the mindset in their own favor. Now we will see what was the condition of ladies, how the ladies were treated in the Nazi Germany. So what we see that particularly the ladies were considered very different from the male members. And what we see, the main responsibility of the ladies was being considered to become a good mother, to bring up their children, and they were also restricted, they were also instructed that they should keep away themselves from the Jews. And if any lady was deviated from these norms, then those ladies were particularly very severely punished and insulted. In the same way, what we see that if any lady follow all these norms, then those ladies were particularly given the privileges. Just like we can see some of the concessions in the railways, in the bus fares, in the movies, just like that. And those ladies were also given a lot of respect in the German society. There was a very particular thing we come to know about the ladies in Nazi Germany, that during the Nazi Germany, ladies were given awards. So particularly those ladies which gave birth up to 4 pure Aryan children, so those ladies were awarded with bronze cross. In the same way, those ladies who gave birth up to 6th, those were awarded with silver, and 8 and more, those ladies were awarded with the gold cross. So in this way, ladies were awarded in Nazi Germany. Why? Because those ladies were cherishing the ideas of Nazism, and those ladies were also considered that they will train their children into the philosophy of Nazism. So this was the we can say concept of Hitler and Nazi towards the ladies, and what we see that it was totally on the basis of discrimination towards the ladies.
So discrimination at its best was being held during the time of Hitler, and it was actually a cult to this womanhood, I would say. They were on all sorts of har tarike ke paimano par pareshan kiya ja raha tha, chahe wo mahilaen ho, chahe wo divyang ho, matlab ab hame sunne ko mil raha hai kaisa raha hai. Ji, you may continue, Pawan Kumar ji. Aage ki baat kya rahi, aur lagbhag hum last segment mein program ki aa gaye hain. Agla jo bhi hum topic discuss kare usko fir conclude karenge.
Okay, ji. So dear learners, now we will see the means art, what was the propaganda. So German and Nazi propaganda was very, we can say, systematic propaganda, and under this propaganda the pictures, the slogans, and particularly movies were used to spread the hatred among the or towards the Jews. In the same way, we will see that what was the reactions of ordinary people. Particularly in Nazi Germany, most of the people, they started to think according to the Nazi views. And when they saw any Jew person, or when they came to know about any Jew person, they were filled with hatred. In the same way, what we see that most of the person were in favor of Nazi's view, but not all. Some of the persons, they also opposed such type of discriminations in Nazi Germany. So in this way, how can we come to know about the Holocaust? This Holocaust means mass killing. So we come to know about it through the diaries, through the reports, and particularly through the government reports. When the Hitler was died and Nazi government was not there in Germany. So students, here is assignment for you. Here are some important questions related to this chapter. You may attempt these questions, you may practice these questions. Questions are before you, and if you have any doubt, you can ask the questions, and read this chapter again by yourself and prepare it. Certainly you will be benefited.
एब्सोल्युटली आपको बहुत बेनिफिट होगा जो भी आज बताया गया है इस सेशन में, आपको इस असाइनमेंट के जरिए एक रिकॉल करना है और जरूर अटेम्प्ट करें असाइनमेंट को और हमसे शेयर करें, आप हमें मेल भी कर सकते हैं। और आज इस वंडरफुल सेशन के लिए आपने पवन जी हमें ज्वाइन किया और बहुत खूबसूरती से समझा दिया इतनी व्यापक हिस्ट्री को हमारे सभी स्टूडेंट्स को, आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। थैंक्स फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस।
थैंक यू कृति एंड थैंक यू माय डियर लर्नर्स
एंड व्यूअर्स, रिमेन कनेक्टेड टू पीएमई विद्या। नेक्स्ट सेशन में वेबिनार में आईसीटी टूल्स डिस्कस किए जाएंगे आपके लिए। अभी के लिए आपसे विदा चाहूंगी, नमस्कार।